wasn't okay. That high pitched.
You had me several years ago. I know I can't sing. I get it.
All right, go ahead.
So I'll stop.
Let's hear you.
Yeah, that's right. Let's hear you. We finally have an answer this morning to one of music's big mysteries. Carly Simon revealed to People magazine she was singing about, wait for it, Warren Beatty in her 1972 hit, You're So Vain. The mystery of the man behind the song has puzzled fans for decades. Michelle Miller shows us why Beatty may not be the only man who's considered so vain. Imagine, Michelle, there's more than one vain man in the world. Good morning to you.
She had it like that, I guess. Good morning. Well, You're So Vain quickly rose to number one after being released 43 years ago this month. And while the song's popularity has endured all the way to 2015, so has one of the greatest questions in music history.
In 40 years, Carly Simon has left her listeners wondering who inspired her 1972 hit song. In an interview with People magazine about her upcoming memoir, Boys in the Trees, Simon confirms the second verse is about Warren Beatty.
When you say
was just one of Simon's well-known lovers speculated to be the song's protagonist. Other candidates have included Mick Jagger, Jack Nicholson, and former husband James Taylor. But the pop star has repeatedly dismissed them all,
with her intuition,
including in a 2001 interview with CBS Sunday Morning.
Everybody thinks You're So Vain is about Mick Jagger.
Oh, they don't really.
Yes, they do.
Okay.
Is it?
Oh, no, no.
And then I read it might be Warren Beatty.
Oh, you know, don't listen to what other people tell you.
Well, do you want to solve that mystery here for us?
You know, I could never solve it, because if I solved it, then no one would have anything to talk to me about.
What Simon will not talk about is the men in the song's other verses, telling People magazine she's keeping quiet, at least until they know it's about them.
In terms of marketing, it's great because Carly is about to release a book, right? And still, she only gave us one of the three names. So I think she's going to take this to the grave with her.
Well, truth be told, Beatty did think the song was about him.
Yeah.
Yes, he did. And
yeah.
Admitting to Britain's Daily Express in 2007 that Simon's memoir, Boys in the Trees, is scheduled for release on Tuesday.
I was wondering why this was coming up now.
Well, you know, the big question I have, obviously everyone has, is who's the yacht man?
Yes.
And who's the Learjet man? Because those are two separate guys out there. So wouldn't you know?
It keeps
wouldn't
me
you know
up,
it's
keep,
you?
It
keeps me up at night.
Well, it is fun to speculate. It's fun. It's fun to play.
You too, Charlie.
Doesn't
I
keep me up.
Charlie's very worried.
He's not vain. How about that?
Thank you, Michelle.
Thank you.